chat, Nifus.
We found that out last night.
That's actually hilarious.
Watch the last 8 minutes of his stream last night. I guarantee you will not be disappointed. But anyway.
So many more questions.
Okay, he's going Palu. Okay. I was going to say, honestly, though, like, Nairo, I feel like he could play any character in the game, basically. Like, any top tier, for sure, at a high level. But the thing is, I feel like, first off, I feel like Palu's okay in this matchup. Like, I don't think it's, like, that bad for her or anything. The other thing is, like, I remember Void fighting against, he could not be, was it?
Shootout.
I'm hip.
Was
no,
it shoot down
a,
or
no,
hit?
It's a local. It was
oh,
a local.
Okay.
He,
I don't know.
He literally couldn't beat him because it was Pichu against Olimar, and then he used Wolf, and he won. I was like, all right, fair enough. So I feel like Wolf pretty good in this matchup, so I don't know, man. He might do it. You know who's not, probably not good in this matchup? Maybe Ganon. Actually,
maybe.
Ganon's kind of scary. He's very
That's
scary.
True. Regardless.
We got to get there first.
Yeah, Dabuz is kind of getting, kind of putting the hands on Nairo right now. I don't really know, like, because the thing about playing Palutena in this matchup is that you're going to have to constantly be in Olimar's wheelhouse. So you need to be confident in that, you know, those falling neutralers are going to connect, that those grabs are going to connect. And the bus is a huge power lineup out on the stage right now as that up smash does connect. So
it's like the worst bar ever. Olimar's wheelhouse. That's terrible, dude.
That's a dive bar.
I'm not there, dude.
They have plastic cups.
Nah, it might be worse, dude. It might be like a hipster bar. Nah,
only vegan options.
Yeah, definitely, dude.
It's a gastro
bar. All vegetarian, yeah. Actually, he doesn't eat the pigment, does he?
He watches them die. I'm sure he wouldn't mind if he watched them get eaten.
That's why I can't play Pikmin, man. You just leave them behind. And then they just die. I'm like, wow, I feel so guilty right now.
I definitely
now.
Killed like 200 Pikmin once. I felt awful about it.
200 is so much, dude. That's so many. That's the thing. He doesn't care about throwing them off stage and dying. He's evil. He's a bad man.
They're tools. They're part of his objective, man.
Oh, God.
They die with honor in his name.
Look at them. They have, like, how big do you think their brains are? Like, they definitely don't know any better.
The Pikmin desperately need to unionize.
Dude, they're autonomous onions.
I forgot they're onions.
They're onion-like.
So you're saying Pikmins have layers, is what you're getting at here.
Many layers.
There we go. Regardless, that's
speaking of layers.
Yeah, that drops out neutral air, able to take that stock from Dabuz, but now left with a layer of damage to make up here.
What a segue.
There you go. There you go. Double fair. Very nice. Keep the pressure on him. That's the thing. Dabuz is so good at recovering with Olimar, too. I feel like not enough people like comment on that. So there you go. Shout out to that. There's something I like about Dabuz.
Hey.
Oh, the way he recovers. Now, I like a lot of things.
Bringing it back.
I love a lot of things about Dabuz.
Without a doubt, man.
Nice. Great use of that back air. Obviously, just can't challenge it. It's a
freaking
shield.
Ooh, sheesh. That was an odd interaction right there. But
wow, that auto reticle was brave. I feel like if Dabuz just went through the platform, ran up and up smash, that would be an hit. But here comes Nairo, dude. Man, he really closed the gap here, too. This is an impressive play.
Yeah, without a doubt. Dabuz kind of having a hard time closing out the stock.
Nairo's catching a lot of trigger options from Dabuz. A lot of spot dodges in place, all that stuff. So here we go. See if he can do it again.
That white Pikmin, they're not saying a
he
chance.
He died with honor, man. Auto Reticle's a really interesting tool in this matchup because it could target the individual Pikmin or Olimar itself. But because it's targeting those Pikmin, the array of the three shots is actually going to cover so much space for Nairo.
Nice. I love that, actually, because he baited down like he was going to try to down air him, but instead caught the jump bag with a fair. Very nice stuff, man. That was just really, really good by Nairo. Baited out the option and got exactly what he wanted.
And one thing I want to highlight is just how well Nairo's been adapting in this set, too. We saw that first stock. It was looking like a chefing, honestly. Like, Dabuz came through, collected, and that was that. But Nairo very quickly changing his tone, moving around a lot more, forcing Dabuz to approach. And when Dabuz isn't allowed to bunker down, throw down his Pikmin, a lot less control is garnered from his stage position.
Yeah, and I was going to say it was going to look kind of grim for Nairo there because he had to bring back that stock so hard. It's going to be hard for him to get any sort of extra credit damage on Dabuz.
Right.
That's also the first time I've ever seen all of our up smash.
Oh,
shield again.
Oh,
nice.
Oh,
mama.
That's a setup off stage, man. The explosive flame. Dabuz did a good job moving around it without using any resources. The problem with that is that he moved further from the stage. Nairo set up, read the air dodge, down air. Very nice stuff, man, coming out from Nairo. Like you said, it didn't look that good. The first stock, it looked like the Dabuz show. You know what I'm saying? It just looked like it was just going to be all Dabuz, but Nairo kind of cracked the code a little bit. It will take down that game one.
Yeah, and he completely erased everything I said about, you know, having to make a comeback from a large percent deficit and then not being able to provide, get the needed extra credit to kind of make the last stock a little bit more comfy for him. Regardless, able to get that read on the air dodge. So let's see what the answer is. The stage is going to be FD.
All right. I think in general this is a really strong pick for Dabuz just because a lot of what he's wanted to do is force the approach from Nairo. Don't let him move around too much. FD being a bit on the smaller end and a lot more room for juggling. Good for Olimar, but might be dangerous against Nairo specifically.
Nairo's happy to just camp it out, man. Whatever. Take that center stage and just chill.
Yeah, it looks like the bell kind of has his bell rung a little bit. He's really not off to the same strong start as he was in the last game. Nairo's the one that's come out the gate really, really
powerful. This is Dabuz's counterpick, too, so he's got an adjustment. But it's early.
Yeah, man, without a doubt.
There's still a lot to be garnered from this. Not much from that. But a lot from it as far as Final Destination is concerned, because one thing to take note, not a lot of ledge play to be seen. And with that...
Nice. Woo! I love the reach on that move. Only one hit, too, I think.
Yeah, that was crazy, man. It's crazy to think that that move is actually stronger in Smash 4.
Is it really?
Yes. Yeah.
I actually did not know that.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, it was a trip in Smash 4, man.
Oh, nice. Great job by Dabuz. That's exactly the type of response you want to see from him, too. Turn the favor of the spike in the first game.
Yeah, Nairo tried to get fancy to kind of mess up Dabuz's timing to give him a shot to get back, but regardless, goes right back to work here on the ledge.
That's what I'm talking about, man. Did you see him deke down? Like, I'm going to the ledge. And then he just comes up and he gets a hit forward, too. That's so smart. I mean, Nairo put it back in the disadvantage very quickly, but it's still nice.
That's one thing that Dabuz has actually been working on really recently. There's been a lot of that winged Pikmin movement, taking advantage of the increased air mobility. And as long as he's got a Pikmin, he's got a strong aerial ahead of him.
Whoa.
Nice. Okay. Check right into the forward arrow. That was like when you punish Falcon or Ganon for upbeating you. You just tech into the stage and hit them afterwards. It reminded me of, but it was Olimar, so it was cool. There we go. Down throw. Back.
Yes. Ooh. Yeah, great use of the whistle. Dabuz has been excellent.
Man.
Yeah, with that whistle usage to able... You know, to get him out of those tricky situations, out of those down throws.
Gotta say, Pal is very good at getting rid of Pikmin, too. You know what I mean? I mean, she's kind of just cruising around nairing anyways. It's just like,
yeah.
All right, you can throw Pikmin.
It's not even extra work for her.
Nice. That F tilt, so active, and it has a lot of reach on it, too. I love that move, actually, and great use of it there by Nairo. He hasn't been using it a whole lot, so it's nice to see him use it and get a stock forward right away.
It's one of those once a set kind of mix-ups.
Not if you're playing against me. It'll work every time.
Take your notes, kids. We're going to beat Hazmat at your local.
How to beat your local Hazmat.
Go for it, man.
Yeah, but let's see what the Buzz's answer is here. Now Nairo's probably going to have to sit back a little bit.
I feel like that's been a thing. Is like the Buzz gets into that like either grab zone, and he's just whipping him, man. And then Nairo's punishing him so hard for it. So, I mean, you want to talk about taking notes. Like, this is a really good way to deal with that kind of distance with Olimar. Between jumping over it or spot dodging or reading his option with his grab, you got to punish it afterwards, too. Nairo's been doing that really, really well. Yep. There you go.
Yeah, there we go. Finally able to get the stock off, but not before eating 92%. So Nairo immediately just going, wasting no time getting right back into the blender right there. That explosive flame going to make things difficult for Dabuz. Waste the jump, but the directional air dodge able to help him. Not for much longer, though, as that back air connects.
That's the thing, man. It's like Olimar, he can rack up damage so fast, and he could kill early with grabs, you know, Pikmin-specific grabs, but also, like, purple up smash and all sorts of different things. Like, he can kill easy, racks up damage, but, dude, he's light. He dies very easily. Like,
yeah,
I think Nairo had him at, like, 80 coming around last stock when he was fresh. It's like, man, that stock's pretty much ready to pop against Palu, especially that close to the blast zone.
And you know Nairo is playing with a chip on his shoulder right now. He is not happy about being dropped in the losers as early as he did.
It's time, fellas.
The ninja?
The ninja coming out.
That's dope.
Done, ninja.
All right, I like that about Dabuz. There you go.
I love the color he's using. This is actually my favorite Greninja color.
It's like almost a shiny. Actually, yeah, no. it's almost a shiny.
Yeah, it's purple, not shiny.
Well, it's like
there is,
I can't tell. Is there?
No,
yeah,
it's
the
purple.
Black one with the red tick. This isn't, but there is in the game.
Yeah.
Anyways, the Greninja is a very more recently practiced character from Dabuz that has just started to see some activity at Aeon, the local that Dabuz participates at on Long Island. And while it may not be winning Aeons, it is definitely putting a dent in the brackets. This is a character that Dabuz intends to take seriously, grind up as a secondary for matchups where he's not as comfortable with. And I think this is a fantastic matchup to pick Greninja into. And there's no better practice anywhere in the world than against Nairo.
Oh.
This deep in the bracket, but he's got to change something about how he's approaching him.
Yeah,
so you're saying that the Palutena is kind of a dead and done thing at this point. He doesn't play Palutena anymore.
Yeah. Nah. Is he going back to Richter? Just kidding. No,
yeah. Please don't.
I'm sorry.
Regardless,
okay.
Yeah.
You don't have to apologize to me.
It's like you said, Hangman. This has definitely got a very pressured situation to be bringing out a secondary that you've only kind of been using. Like you said, he's making dents in the Aeon bracket, but the level of competition has obviously escalated much higher here. But we'll see if it works out for him. Nairo's still relatively unscathed.
Yeah, I mean, 36%, man.
He's not going to even have to clean the dress after this, probably.
And, like, the worst part about this is, like, Dabuz is finding himself in one of the sole weaknesses of Greninja, and that being when he's ledge trash.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, Nairo's on a warpath. You see that? The chart. He's like a bull, dude. He's like, all right, parry this, hit you. Like, I'm just running in, dude.
Nairo's mad, dude. He doesn't want to be fighting Dabuz for 7 minutes right now.
Earlier, I was going to say if they were Avengers, that Nairo's Captain America because he's using the shield from Palo. I'm like, nah, he's the Hulk. He's hulking out, man. Like, he's just charging through everything.
He's Captain Hulk.
Captain, yeah. Hulk America. Hulkamania. We're at Suplex.
Run a wild!
I made an anime and a wrestling reference in one day, dude.
Let me tell you something, brother. That explosive flame was expertly placed on the part of Nairo. That is all the wrestling jokes you'll get out of me tonight. Yeah, thank
same,
you.
Same. I'm spent, dude. I can talk about The Rock, maybe, and that's about it, dude. He's
I can wrestler, talk about right? The Rock and the Tooth Fairy.
That counters in general in this game last forever. They last. Crazy. You really have to respect how long they linger for.
Especially because Palu's also doubles as a reflector. That was kind of crazy.
He's cute.
He's feeling it, man. He's feeling it. So even if he has D's there, he's like, I'm so good. But he's not going to SD. He's Nairo. Well, the percent chance is very low.
Wow. Goes for the forward throw for safe positioning.
There he feigned the down to the ledge, so he forced the buzz to go low. Scoop down. Nice. Okay. The recovery master, but still getting Trump there. Back air. Nice job by Nairo. Trey, oh.
Liquid Dabuz is out at 7th place here for Suplex City tonight.
And Nairo moves on with a rematch with Leon in Loser's
Quarter. Is that really gonna happen?
Boy, yeah.
Jesus. He wants that run back, you know what I'm saying?
Nairo! As Stu brings us back into what's going on here.
Oh, man. I want Stu to just talk about stuff, you know what I'm saying? Oh,
yeah, man. Okay. I wish we could get some warning when Stu's actually going to start announcing so we don't, like, talk over
it. He's like a wild animal, man.
We just have to respect him.
There you go.